Hi and welcome to a new tutorial, this new blanket, Candy Floss Daydreams. This is a design of Catherine Bly. Catherine gave me permission to explain this beautiful blanket to you on my channel. If you want to visit the website of Catherine Bly, then click the link below this video. There you find the written pattern and all the colors yarn that Catherine working with. I use Color Crafter from Scheepjes. It's a 100% premium acrylic yarn, 100 gram and 300 meters yarn on one ball. The five colors that I used, color 1068 Den Helder, color 1080 Venlo, color 1240 Omen, color 1218 Zandvoort and color 1064 Veenendaal. You'll find under this video and on my website biancascrochetparlors.com how many balls you need in total. I'm working with a 4mm crochet hook. Let's get started! In part 4 we make square number 12 and we need to make 4 of these in total. With the first color we begin with a magic circle. Then a chain 3. 1, 2, and 3, and this counts for a first double crochet. Into the magic circle we work 11 double crochets. Yarn over, enter hook in the circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over and pull for 2. That's the first of 11. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. With your first chain 3 here in the beginning, we have 12 double crochets in total. Now pull on that short beginning yarn to tie close the circle. And now we work a slip stitch into the first double crochet, and that's that chain 3 on the top of the third chain stitch. There we make the join slip stitch. Round 2, and we start with a chain 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, counts for a double crochet plus a chain 1. Into the same stitch you make a double crochet, and that's the stitch where you make in the previous round that slip stitch. Now we have this. A double crochet, a chain 1 and a double crochet into the same stitch. The repeat of this round into the next stitch. 2 double crochets in the same stitch. One back in that same stitch for a second double crochet. 2. Into the next stitch we work a double crochet, chain 1 and a double crochet. Double crochet, chain 1 and a double crochet into the same stitch. And this is the repeat of this round. Into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in the same stitch. That's 1. Back in that same stitch 2. Into the next stitch, 1 double crochet, and chain 1, and a double crochet into the same stitch. Work so all the way around, and then we make an invisible join in the beginning. I'm almost round into the last stitch. We work 2 double crochets in the same stitch. And now we make an invisible join in the beginning. We cut the yarn. And open up that stitch. And with a needle, we make that invisible join, not in the first stitch. And that's that chain 3. Counts for a double crochet. We skip that stitch, we go to the next stitch, and that's the chain 1. Under through that V stitch, like this, from the front to the back, then pull through, go to the last stitch, that's the last double crochet on the top, only in the back loop, and pull through. On the back we make a little knot, pull a little loop, then pull. Wave both tails in on the back of your work. Round 3, and we make a slip knot on the hook with a new color. And we begin with a standing double crochet in any chain 1 space. That's between the 2 double crochets. In that chain 1 space, we begin with a standing double crochet. Into that same space, we work 3 double crochets, chain 2, and 4 double crochets. That's 1, back in that same space, 2, and 3. Now we have here 4 double crochets in total, make a chain 2. And back in that same space with another 4 double crochets. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Make a chain 1 and then we skip the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, and now in that next chain 1 space, we make another 4 double crochets, chain 2, 4 double crochets into that same space. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4, then in chain 2. And 4 double crochets into the same space. And this is the repeat that we work all the way around. Make a chain one and then skip the next four stitches. And then into the next chain one space, four double crochets. Chain two, four double crochets into the same space. Work so all the way around, and in the beginning we make an invisible join. And that invisible join you make in that second stitch. I'm all the way around. I have to make a chain one on the end. And now we cut the yarn to make that invisible join. Open that stitch. Invisible join we make always on the second stitch. We skip that first standing double crochet. We go to the next stitch, under through that V-stitch. Go back to the last stitch, only in the back loop. And then wave both tails in on the back of your work. Round 4 with a new color on the hook, and we begin with a standing single crochet in an any chain 2 space. And that's between the two groups of 4 double crochets. A standing single crochet. Into that same stitch we work 2 single crochets. That's 1. And 2. Now we start on the repeat of this round. Make a chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and now we work a front post treble crochet 4 together across the next 4 double crochets of round 2. Yarn twice over the hook and then go to round 2. In that first double crochet, grab your yarn and pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Now you stop. You make that treble not complete. Yarn twice over the hook and go to the next double crochet of round 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn twice over your hook into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, and once more. Yarn twice over the hook, into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. Now we have 5 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all the 5 loops to work those trebles together. And chain 3. 1, 2, 3. And we skip the next 8 stitches of round 3. And we work a 3 single crochet into the next chain 2 space of round 3. That's 1. Back in that same space. 2. And 3. And this is the repeat that we work all the way around. I'll show you once more. Make and chain 3. Then skip the next 8 stitches of round 3 and then you work a front post treble crochet 4 together across the next 4 double crochets of round 2. And you see that I make here a mistake. I make not a front post 4 together, but I work in those stitches. That's my fault. For a front post, you work around that double crochet from the front to the back, from the back to the front. But if you make those front post treble crochets together like this, it's also fine. Then and chain 3. Skip the next 8 stitches. That brings us to the next chain 2 space and work 3 single crochets in that space. Work all the way around and then in the beginning we make an invisible join into the second stitch. I'm all the way around, I make the chain 3 on the end, cut the yarn and make an invisible join. Open up that stitch. And that invisible join we make not in that first stitch but in the second. Round 5 with a new color on the hook and we begin with a standing single crochet in the second single crochet of any 3 single crochet group. That's on the point here in the middle, that second stitch. And then into that same stitch you work 2 single crochets. That's 1, back in the same stitch for a second. We start on the repeat of this round, into the next stitch 1 single crochet, then 3 single crochets in the chain 3 space, 1, 2 and 3, then we skip the next front post treble crochet 4 together. Then and 3 single crochets into the next chain 3 space. That's 1, 2 and 3 and a single crochet into the next stitch. And into the next stitch you work 3 single crochets. That's 1, 2 and 3. This is the repeat of this round. The last 3 single crochets is the same than the first 3 single crochets in that same stitch. I'll show you once more the repeat. Into the next stitch 1 single crochet, then 3 single crochets into the chain 3 space. 1. Now we skip the next front post treble crochet 4 together and work 3 single crochets into the next chain 3 space. 1. Then a single crochet into the next stitch. And into the next stitch 3 single crochets in the same stitch. Wuxel all the way around, and then we join with a slip stitch into the beginning single crochet. I'm all the way around and make a slip stitch into the beginning single crochet. That's that standing single crochet here on the top, a slip stitch. Round 6 with the same color on the hook, and we begin with a chain 1 and a single crochet into the same stitch where you make in the previous round, that slip stitch. Now work 3 single crochets into the next stitch. That's 1, back in the same stitch, 2 and 3. And a single crochet into the next 10 stitches. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, into the next, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. And you work that last single crochet in the first single crochet of that group of 3 of the previous round. Into the next stitch, you work 3 single crochets into the same stitch. 1, 2 and 3. And this is the repeat you work all the way around. And then we work into the second stitch and a visible join. I'm all the way around. On the end I make 9 single crochets in total. It must be 10. In the beginning we work also already 1 single crochet. That's 10 together. Cut the yarn and make an invisible join. An invisible join we make in the second stitch. Round 7 with a new color on the hook, and we begin with a standing 3 double crochet cluster in the second single crochet of any 3 single crochet group. That's on the top here. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in that stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2. Yarn over the hook, go back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over the hook, into the same stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, 4 loops on the hook, yarn over and work together. That's the first cluster. Make a chain 2, 1 and 2, and go back into the same stitch and make another cluster of 3 double crochets together. That's 1, yarn over, into the same stitch, 2, yarn over, into the same stitch, 3, yarn over and pull through all the 4 loops and make a chain 2. Back in that same stitch and make a third cluster of 3 double crochets together. That's 1, two, three, and work together. Yarn over, pull through 4 loops. We restart on the repeat of this round. Make a chain 1. Then skip the next stitch and work a 3 double crochet cluster into the next stitch. Skip 1 and in this stitch you work a 3 double crochet cluster. That's 1, 2, 3 double crochets and work together. Now we skip the next 4 stitches and working into the skipped front post treble crochet 4 together from round 5. That's below here into that stitch. We work a treble crochet, chain 2 and a treble crochet in that stitch. Only in that stitch. Fold your work to the back to create more space. Yarn twice over, go into that stitch of round 5, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2 and pull through 2 for a treble crochet. And chain 2 and back in that same stitch with another treble crochet. Yarn over the hook twice, that's 1, 2, 3 times pull through 2 loops. Now we skip the next 4 stitches of round 6. And then into the next stitch, you work a 3 double crochet cluster together. That's 1, 2, and 3 doubles work together. Then make a chain 1 and skip the next stitch, and then into the next stitch you work 3 double crochet cluster. You make a new group of these like this here. It's 1, 2 and 3 and work together. Then in chain 2, into the same stitch a new 3 double crochet cluster. And work those together. And in chain 2, and a cluster of 3 double crochets into that same stitch. And this is the repeat. Work all these stitches after those 3 clusters here in the beginning. All these stitches all the way around, and then we join with an invisible join in the beginning 3 double crochet cluster here on the top. And you start the repeat with a chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and then into the next stitch and cluster of 3 double crochets. Work all your stitches all the way around, and then in the beginning we make that invisible join. I'm all the way around, I cut the yarn, and now we make an invisible join on the top of that cluster. Go to the last stitch, only in the back loop. Round 8, and we make a slip knot on the hook with a new color, and we begin with a standing single crochet in the second cluster of any group of 3 clusters. On the top here we make a standing single crochet. Into that same stitch 2 single crochets. That's 1. Back in that same stitch for a second. Now we start on the repeat of this round. 2 single crochets in that chain 2 space. That's that space here. That's 1. back in that same space. 2. A single crochet in the next cluster. On the top, 1 single crochet. And then a single crochet in the next chain 1 space. We skip the next cluster and also the next treble crochet. And then we work 4 double crochets, chain 2, 4 double crochets into the next chain 2 space. Here in the middle, between the 2 trebles, we start with 4 double crochets in that space. 1, 2, 3, 4, then and chain 2, 1 and 2, and back in that same space with 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. We skip the next treble crochet and the next cluster. Then a single crochet into the next chain 1 space. On the top of the next cluster, 1 single crochet. And then into the next chain 2 space, between the 2 clusters, 2 single crochets. In that space is 1 and 2. Now into the next cluster, is the 3rd cluster here in the middle, we make on the top 3 single crochets. 1, 2 and 3. And this is the repeat of this round. After that first 3 single crochets here in the beginning, all these stitches 5 more times, and then in the beginning we join with an invisible join in the second single crochet. We skip that first standing single crochet, this stitch here, and we go to the second stitch, and that's the point where we make that invisible join. Round 9 with a new color, and we begin with a standing single crochet in the second single crochet of any 3 single crochets group. And that's on the point of the second cluster. And standing single crochet. Into that same stitch, make 2 single crochets. That's 1, back in that same stitch, 2. The repeat of this round. We begin with a single crochet in the next 3 stitches. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, and into the next 3. Skip the next 2 stitches, and then we make a front post treble crochet around the first treble crochet of the treble crochet, chain 2 and the treble crochet from round 7. Yarn twice over, then go to that first treble crochet here on the right of round 7, go around that stitch, fold your work to the back, and work that treble crochet. Like this. We skip the next stitch of round 8, and then we make a back post half double crochet around the next 3 stitches. Yarn over, skip 1 stitch, then go around the next stitch on the back, and work a back post half double crochet. That's the first of 3. Go around the next stitch and back post half double crochet and around the next stitch and back post half double crochet. And you see here all these little stitches on the front of the stitches. And single crochet into the next chain 2 space. And then and back post half double crochet around the next 3 stitches. Go around the first double crochet. On the back you work and back post half double crochet. That's 1. Around the next stitch. 2. And around the next stitch. 3. We skip the next stitch and we make a front post treble crochet around the second treble crochet of the 2 treble crochets, chain 2, 2 treble crochets from around 7. Go around that stitch and work a treble crochet. Now we skip the next 2 stitches of round 8. 1 and 2, and then a single crochet in the next 3 stitches. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, and in the next 3. And then into the next stitch, you work 3 single crochets into that same stitch, and that's the second single crochet of the 3 single crochets of the previous round. That's 1, 2, and 3, and this is the repeat of this round. These 3 single crochets are the same than the first 3 single crochets. Repeat all these stitches 5 more times, and then we make an invisible join in the beginning in the second single crochet of this round. A new color is on the hook in round 10, and we begin with a standing single crochet in the second single crochet of any group of 3 single crochets. That's on the top here. Then in the second single crochet, that's the point where we start with a standing single crochet. Into that same stitch, 2 single crochets. That's 1, back in that same stitch, 2. The repeat of this round. We skip the next 3 stitches and make a 4 double crochet into the next stitch. That's 1, into the same stitch, 2. 3 and 4. Also into the next stitch, and that's that front post treble crochet, you work also 4 double crochets in that stitch. That's 1, back in the same stitch, 2, 3 and 4. Skip the next 3 stitches and make into the next stitch 3 single crochets. And that's on the top of that single crochet of the previous round. That's 1, 2, and 3. Skip the next 3 stitches, and then on the top of the next treble crochet, front post treble crochet, you work 4 double crochets into the same stitch. Also into the next stitch, 4 double crochets in the same stitch. That's number 4. You skip the next 3 stitches, 1, 2, and 3, and then into the next stitch, 3 single crochets in the same stitch. That's 1, 2, and 3. And this is the repeat of this round. After those 3 single crochets, in the beginning you work all these stitches all the way around, and then we make an invisible join into the second single crochet of this round. Round 11, we make a slip knot on the hook with a new color, and we begin with a standing back post half double crochet around the first single crochet of round 10. And now we work all the way around into the next 131 stitches with a back post half double crochet. Make all these stitches all the way around, and then we make an invisible join in the beginning, not in the first but in the second back post half double crochet. Round 12 with a new color on the hook, and we start with a standing back post half double crochet around the first back post half double crochet of the previous round. That's on the top of the clusters where we make the 3 single crochets, where we make in the first single crochet the first back post half double crochet. That's the point where we start with a standing back post half double crochet around that stitch. And we make this round the same than the previous round. Around every stitch you work a back post half double crochet. That's 131 stitches in total. All the way around. And then in the beginning we close this round with a slip stitch in the beginning back post half double crochet. I'm all the way around and make a slip stitch into the first standing back post half double crochet on the top here. Yarn over, then pull through and pull through. Round 13 with the same color on the hook, and in this round I use also stitch markers. We begin with a chain 1 and make a single crochet into the same stitch, and also a single crochet into the next 5 stitches. That's 2 and 3. 4 and 5. Now we start on the repeat of this round. Make a chain one and skip the next two stitches. One and two. And then into the next stitch, we make a 3 double crochet cluster. That's one, two, and 3 double crochets. And work together for a cluster. And chain one. And back into the same stitch with another 3 double crochet cluster. That's one, two, and three, and work together and make a chain one. Back in the same stitch with another cluster of 3 double crochets. That's one, two, and three, and work together. And then we make also a chain one after the third cluster. We skip the next two stitches and make a single crochet into the next 6 stitches. That's one into the next stitch, two into the next, three, four, five, and 6. And now with the stitch marker, we make that stitch marker into the third single crochet of these 6 single crochets. It's 1, 2, and 3. In that stitch, we place that stitch marker in. We need this for round 15. We go further with a chain one and skip the next 2 stitches, and then we make into the next stitch a new cluster of 3 double crochets together. That's 1, 2, and 3, and work that cluster together. A chain one, back in that same stitch with another 3 double crochet cluster. A chain one, and back in that same stitch with a new 3 double crochet cluster. And then we make a chain one. We skip the next 2 stitches and make into the next 6 stitches 1 single crochet. That's one into the next stitch, two into the next, three, four, five, and 6. Skip the next 2 stitches and then we make a 4 double crochet into the next stitch. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Make a chain 2, 1 and 2, and back in that same stitch with another 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. We skip the next 2 stitches and make a single crochet into the next 6 stitches. Skip 2, into the next stitch, a single crochet, and that's the first of 6. It's 1. Into the next stitch, 2, into the next, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And this is the repeat of this round. Work so all these stitches all the way around, and the repeat, we start with the 3 clusters of the three double crochets together. That's the point where we start here. Then make 6 single crochets. And then place that stitch marker in the third single crochet stitch. Make another clusters of 3 double crochets together. And then this point here. Work so all the way around. And then in the beginning, you make an invisible join into the second stitch of this round. That's the point here. Not in the first, but in the second stitch. There you work that invisible join. I'm almost done with this round. I place in total 4 stitch markers in. Now in the beginning we have a cluster and a point. A cluster and a next point. Clusters, clusters and a point. Clusters, clusters, and I have to make 1 more point. Skip the next 2 stitches and make 4 double crochets into that stitch. Then and chain 2 and 4 double crochets into the same stitch. Now I cut the yarn and make that invisible join in the beginning. Open that stitch. And we skip that first stitch. That's here that chain 1 and that single crochet into the same stitch. We skip that stitch. We go to the second single crochet. That's the point where we make that invisible join. Round 14 with a new color on the hook, and we begin with a standing single crochet in the last double crochet of any group of 4 double crochets, chain 2, 4 double crochets. Then in the last double crochet on the top here, there we start with a standing single crochet. We skip the next 2 stitches and then into the next stitch you work 3 double crochets into the same stitch. It's 1, 2, and in the third stitch you work and 3 double crochets in the same stitch. That's 1, back in the same stitch, 2, and 3. Also into the next stitch, 3 double crochets in the same stitch. It's 1, 2, and 3. We skip the next 4 stitches and make 3 single crochets into the chain 1 space. It's 1, 2, 3, that's a chain 1, 4 is the cluster, and then into the next chain 1 space, there we make the 3 single crochets. That's 1, 2, and 3. We skip the next cluster and make in the next chain 1 space 3 single crochets. One, 2, and 3. We skip the next 4 stitches. That's 1, 2, 3 and 4. And then into the next stitch, and that's the stitch of the stitch marker, you work 3 double crochets into the same stitch. That's 1. Two and three, and also into the next stitch, 3 double crochets into the same stitch. That's 1, 2, and 3. Skip the next 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3. And 4, and into the next chain 1 space, work 3 single crochets, 1, 2, and 3. We skip the next cluster, and into the next chain 1 space, 3 single crochets, 1, 2, and 3. We skip the next 4 stitches. That's the cluster, chain 1, 3 and 4, and then into the next stitch, 3 double crochets in the same stitch, 1, 2 and 3, and 3 double crochets into the next stitch, 1, 2 and 3. Now we skip the next 2 stitches and make into the next 3 stitches 1 single crochet. That's 1 into the next stitch, 2 and into the next 3. Make a chain 3. Now we skip the next double crochet, chain 2 and double crochet. That's the double crochet, and then into the next stitch, 1 single crochet. Now we have here a little loop on the back of our work. Into the next 2 stitches, also 1 single crochet. And this is the repeat of this round. These 3 single crochets here on the end are the same than the 3 single crochets here in the beginning. Repeat all these stitches all the way around 3 more times, and then in the beginning we make an invisible join to close this round. And that invisible join we make not in that first stitch but in the second stitch. Round 15 with a new color on the hook, and we begin with a standing double crochet in any chain 2 space of round 13, and that's in the point here, and be sure that the chain 3 space, that loop behind your work, we're not going to work in that space, only in that chain 2 space of round 13. A standing double crochet in that space, and then 4 double crochets in the same space. That makes 5 double crochets in total in that same space. That's 3 and 4 and 5. 5 double crochets into that same space. We start on the repeat of this round. Make a chain 3. 1, 2, and 3, and we skip the next 3 stitches of round 14 and work a back post half double crochet around the next 6 stitches. That's 1, on the next stitch and 2 around the next, 3 4 5 and 6. Now we make a front post half double crochet around the cluster from round 13. That's here. That cluster here. Go around that cluster and work a front post half double crochet. Now we skip the next stitch of round 14 and make a single crochet into the next 2 stitches. That's 1 into the next stitch and 2. A front post half double crochet around the next cluster of round 13. That's this cluster here. We do not skip the next stitch of round 14. We go straight to the next stitch and work a single crochet into the next 2 stitches. That's 1 into the next stitch. Also 1 single crochet. Around the next cluster of round 13, you make also a front post half double crochet. You skip the next stitch of round 14 and work a front post treble crochet around the marked single crochet of round 13. That's this stitch here, the marked stitch. In that stitch we're going to work. And you make a front post treble crochet around the marked single crochet. Twice over, go around that stitch, fold your work to the back, and make that front post treble crochet. You skip the next stitch of round 14. And then into the next 4 stitches, you work 1 single crochet. That's 1 into the next stitch, 2 into the next, 3 and into the next 4. And we go back to the single crochet of round 13 for a second time with a front post treble crochet. Around that same stitch and work that front post treble crochet. We skip the next stitch of round 14 and then we make a front post half double crochet around the next cluster from round 13. That's that cluster here. A front post half double crochet. Skip the next stitch of round 14 and then we make a single crochet into the next 2 stitches. That's 1 into the next stitch, 2, and then work a front post half double crochet around the next cluster of round 13. Now we skip not a stitch on round 14, go to the next stitch, work a single crochet and also into the next stitch, a single crochet. A front post half double crochet around the next cluster. Then we skip the next stitch of round 14. And then we make a back post half double crochet around the next 6 stitches. That's 1 round the next stitch, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Make a chain 3, 1, 2, 3, we skip the next 3 stitches from round 14, and then we work a 5 double crochet into the chain 2 space from round 13. That's this space here in the next point, and be sure that the chain 3 of the loop behind our work, we do not working into that stitch in that space, only in that chain 2 space of round 13. 5 double crochets in that space, and that's the repeat of this round. Repeat all these stitches after that first 5 double crochets here. Repeat all these stitches all the way around, and then we make a slip stitch in the beginning double crochet, that's in the top of that first standing double crochet. My last stitches. Make a chain 3 on the end, and then on the top of that first standing double crochet, you make a slip stitch. Round 16 with the same color on the hook, and we make a slip stitch into the next stitch. Then a chain 1, and into the same stitch back with a single crochet. 3 single crochets into the next stitch. 1 in that same stitch, 2, and into the same stitch, 3. Then a single crochet into the next stitch. Skip the next stitch, and then working in the front of the chain 3 from round 15, and work 5 double crochets into the second of the 3 skipped single crochets of round 14. That's this stitch here, and be sure that you work the chain stitches to the back. You're working only in that stitch of round 14. That's 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 double crochets into that same stitch. A single crochet into the next 6 stitches of round 15. One into the next stitch, 2 into the next, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we skip the next stitch and make a single crochet in the next 12 stitches. 1 into the next stitch, 2 into the next, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. We skip the next stitch, and then into the next 12 stitches, 1 single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, one to go, 12. Now we're working also in the front of the chain 3 from round 15. In the second stitch of the 3 skipped single crochets of round 15, and there we make 5 double crochets in that stitch. It's 1, back in the same stitch, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we skip the next stitch of round 15 and make a single crochet into the next stitch. Skip one stitch and then into the next stitch, that single crochet. And that's complete the repeat of this round. Into the next stitch, we start all over with the next repeat. 3 single crochets in that stitch. And into the next stitch, 1 single crochet. This corner is the same corner than the first corner. After that single crochet here, after that 3 single crochets, repeat all these stitches 3 more times and then make an invisible join in the beginning, not in the first but in the second stitch. New colors on the hook with the slip knot in round 17, and we begin with a standing double crochet in the second of a 3 single crochet corner group. That's the point here. And standing double crochet in that stitch. Into the same stitch, 1 double crochet. Then a chain 2, 1, 2, and back in that same stitch with another 2 double crochets to complete the first corner. It's 1 and 2. Now we start on the repeat of this round. We skip the next 2 stitches, then working behind the 5 double crochets of round 16 and work 7 double crochets into the chain 3 space of round 15. That's behind our work here. There we make 7 double crochets into that space. Only in that space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. It's behind our work. Skip the next 5 double crochets of round 16 and skip the next single crochet of round 16. Then we make a single crochet into the next 5 stitches. Skip that little stitch here in the beginning and then into the next stitch. We make a single crochet. That's the first of 5. That's 1 into the next stitch, 2 into the next, 3, 4, and 5. Now we make a front post double crochet around the front post half double crochet of round 15. That's this stitch here. We work around that stitch with a front post half double crochet. Yarn over, go around that stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and then pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. Skip the next stitch and then we make a single crochet into the next two stitches. That's one. And into the next stitch. Two. Now we work a front post double crochet around the front post half double crochet of round 15. We skip the next stitch and a single crochet into the next two stitches. A front post double crochet around the front post half double crochet of round 15. And skip the next stitch and a single crochet into the next two stitches. That's one and into the next stitch. Two. Make a chain one and then we skip the next stitch and work a single crochet into the next two stitches. That's one, into the next stitch, two. A front post double crochet around the front post half double crochet of round 15. And skip one stitch. And a single crochet into the next two stitches. One and two. A front post double crochet around the half of the front post half double crochet from round 15. And we skip the next stitch. And a single crochet into the next two stitches. And again a front post double crochet around the front post half double crochet from round 15. Skip the next stitch and then a single crochet in the next four stitches. That's one, into the next stitch, two, in the next, three, and four. Then we skip the next stitch and working behind the five double crochets from round 16. And we work in that chain 3 loop space 7 double crochets in that space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now we skip the 5 double crochets and the next 2 single crochets of round 16. And work into the next stitch 2 double crochets in the same stitch, that's 1, back in the same stitch for a second, and chain 2 and 2 double crochets into the same stitch. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Repeat all these stitches after that first corner 3 more times. And then we join with a slip stitch in the beginning double crochet. And we make a slip stitch into the first standing double crochet to complete round 17. Round 18 with the same color and we make a slip stitch into the next stitch and also a slip stitch into the next chain 2 space. Then we make a chain 3 and this chain 3 counts for a first double crochet. Into the same space of the chain 2 we work 2 double crochets, a chain 2 and 3 double crochets into the same chain 2 space. Now we start on the repeat of this round. We skip the next 2 stitches and make in the next stitch 1 double crochet, chain 1, 1 double crochet into the same stitch. Skip 2 stitches and double crochet into the next stitch, chain 1 and a double crochet in that same stitch. We skip the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and make in the next stitch 1 double crochet, chain 1 and 1 double crochet into the same stitch. And that we do one more time. We skip the next 2 stitches, then into the next stitch and double crochet, chain 1 and a double crochet into the same stitch. Now we skip the next 2 stitches and make a double crochet into the next stitch. Into the next 2 stitches, 1 half double crochet. That's 1. And into the next stitch, also a half double crochet, 2. A single crochet into the next 9 stitches. That's 1, into the next, 2, into the next, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And now into the next chain 1 space, we work also a single crochet. See in the middle of the square? A single crochet into the next 8 stitches. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Into the next 2 stitches, 1 half double crochet. That's 1, and into the next stitch, 2, and a double crochet into the next stitch. Now we skip the next 2 stitches and make a double crochet into the next stitch. A chain 1 and a double crochet into the same stitch. Skip the next 2 stitches. And into the next stitch a double crochet, chain 1. And a double crochet into the same stitch. We skip 2 stitches and double crochet into the next stitch and chain 1 and a double crochet into the same stitch. We skip the next 2 stitches and then we make a new corner in that chain 2 space, 3 double crochets in that space. 1, 2, 3, make a chain 2, and 3 double crochets into the same space. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Repeat all these stitches after the first corner here 3 more times. And then in the beginning, we make an invisible join, not in that first stitch, that's the chain 3 counts for a double crochet, but in the second. Here's the chain 3, we skip those stitches, and then on the first double crochet, that's the point where we make that invisible join. Round 19 with a new color on the hook, and we begin with a standing double crochet in an any corner chain 2 space. And in that same space, we make a new corner of 2 double crochets, a chain 2, and back in that same space with 3 double crochets. To complete the first corner, we skip the next 4 stitches and work in the chain 1 space 5 double crochets. And that's in that V stitch here. 5 double crochets in that space. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we skip the next 2 stitches and make a single crochet in the chain 1 space of the next V stitch. We skip the next 2 stitches and work in the next chain 1 space, and that's also in the next V stitch, 5 double crochets. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Skip the next 3 stitches and make a single crochet into the next 9 stitches. 1 into the next stitch, 2 in the next, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we work a 3 double crochet cluster, chain 1, 3 double crochet cluster, and chain 1, and a 3 double crochet cluster in the skipped single crochet of round 16. And that's this stitch here, that's the skipped stitch of round 16. There we make our first cluster of 3 double crochets together. Only in that stitch, fold your work to the back to create more space and make a 3 double crochet cluster. It's 1, 2, and 3. Work together and then make a chain 1. Another cluster of 3 double crochets together in that same stitch. And a chain 1, and a cluster of 3 double crochets into that same stitch. Work together. Now we have 3 clusters into that same stitch. We skip the next 3 stitches of round 18, and then a single crochet into the next 9 stitches. That's 1, then into the next stitch, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. skip the next 2 stitches and make a 5 double crochet in the next chain 1 space. That's in that V stitch. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then we skip the next 2 stitches and make a single crochet into the next chain 1 space in that V stitch. Skip the next 2 stitches and then in the next V stitch also 5 double crochets in that same space, chain 1 space. That's 3, 4, and 5. Skip the next 4 stitches and then we make a new corner in that chain 2 corner space of 3 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and chain 2 and 3 double crochets into the same space to complete corner 2. And this is the same corner than the first corner. Repeat all the stitches after the first corner here 3 more times and then make in the beginning an invisible join in the second stitch, not that first standing double crochet, but in the second double crochet. Round 20 with a new color on the hook and we begin in a corner space with a standing half double crochet. Into that same space a half double crochet, a chain 2 and 2 half double crochets into the same space. That's 1 and 2. A half double crochet into the next 2 stitches. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, and work a 3 double crochet together across the second 3 double crochets of the 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet from round 18. Yarn over, go to the first double crochet, fold your work to the back, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over into the next stitch, grab your yarn, yarn over, pull through 2, 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and work together. Now we skip the next stitch of round 19 and then we work an back post half double crochet around the next 5 stitches. These are these stitches here. Yarn over, go around that first double crochet and on the back you work that back post half double crochet. That's 1, around the next stitch, 2, around the next stitch, 3, 4, and 1 more, 5. A front post half double crochet around the next stitch. That's that little single crochet here of the previous round. Go around that single crochet and work a front post half double crochet. Then a back post half double crochet around the next 5 stitches. That's one. Around the next stitch. Two. Three. Four. And five. A single crochet into the next 8 stitches. That's one into the next 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we make and chain one and skip the next stitch and working behind the cluster group of round 19 and work a half double crochet in each of the 3 skipped stitches from round 18. That's behind the clusters here. Each skipped stitch you work a half double crochet in that stitch. That's the first, a half double crochet, then into the next stitch, that's 2, and into the next stitch, 3. Make a chain 1 and skip the next stitch. And make a single crochet into the next 8 stitches. 1 into the next stitch. 2 3 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now we work a back post half double crochet around the next 5 stitches. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And front post half double crochet around the next stitch. And that's that single crochet. And then around the next 5 stitches and back post half double crochet. And the last one, 5. Now we work on 3 double crochet together across the first 3 double crochet stitches here of round 19. Yarn over, go to the first stitch of round 19 and move your work to the back. Into the next stitch and into the next stitch and work those 3 double crochets together. Skip the next stitch of round 19 and then we work a half double crochet into the next 2 stitches. That's 1 and into the next stitch 2 and we make in the corner chain 2 corner space a new corner of 2 half double crochets, chain 2 and 2 half double crochets. Repeat all the stitches after the first corner here. 3 more times and then we make a slip stitch into the first stitch. I'm all the way around and I make the slip stitch here in the beginning to close this round. Round 21 with the same color and we begin with a chain and then a single crochet into the same stitch. And also into the next stitch a single crochet. Now in that chain 2 corner space we make a new corner of 3 single crochets in that space. 1, 2, 3. We skip the first stitch, and that's the stitch here after the chain 2 corner space. We skip that stitch and go to the next stitch and work a single crochet, and that's the first of 19 single crochets. We skip to the next stitch. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and the last 19 single crochets. And front post double crochet around the middle front post double crochet from round 17. That's this stitch here. Go around your hook twice, go around that stitch, fold your work to the back, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pulled for 2, yarn over, pulled for 2, yarn over, pulled for 2. We skip the next stitch of round 20 and then we work a single crochet into the next 3 stitches. 1, 2, and 3. A front post half double crochet around the first cluster from round 19. Yarn over the hook, go around that first cluster here and work a front post half double crochet. Then skip the chain 1 space and the next stitch of round 20 and then a single crochet into the next stitch. This stitch here, a single crochet. A front post half double crochet around the second cluster of round 19. Yarn over, go around the second cluster and make that front post half double crochet. Skip the next stitch of round 20 and work a single crochet into the next chain 1 space. Then a front post half double crochet around the third cluster of round 19. And skip the next stitch of round 20 and make a single crochet into the next 3 stitches. Skip 1 stitch and then go to the next stitch. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, and also into the next stitch, 3. And front post treble crochet around the middle front post double crochet of round 17. Go around the hook twice, go around that stitch, and work that front post treble crochet. Skip the next stitch of round 20 and then work a single crochet into the next 19 stitches. That's 1, go to the next stitch, 2, into the next, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and the last single crochet, 19. And now in that chain 2 corner space, we make a new corner of 3 single crochets in that same space. Repeat all the stitches after that first corner of the 3 single crochets here. Repeat all these stitches 3 more times and then make an invisible join in the beginning single crochet. Not the first, but in the second. I'm all the way around. I make on the end 17 single crochets. It must be 19. Here in the beginning we work already 2 single crochets. That's 19 in total. Cut the yarn and with the needle we make the invisible join, not in the first but in the second single crochet. And this is all the yarn that is left over from this blue color. Round 22 with a new color on the hook, and this is the final round of the square. And we begin with a standing single crochet in the second single crochet of an any corner 3 single crochets. Into that same stitch you make 2 single crochets. That's 1 and 2 for the first corner. Now we make a single crochet in the next 53 stitches. All the way to the next corner, and then in the corner space we work also 3 single crochets in the second stitch of the corner of a group of 3 single crochets. In each stitch to the next corner a single crochet, and that's 53 stitches in total. I make all the way around single crochets, and in each corner 3 single crochets. I cut the yarn, open that stitch, and make that last invisible join of this square. Not in that first standing single crochet, but in the second single crochet. Go to the last single crochet only in the back loop. And then work both tails in on the back of your work. I make a little knot. And weave both threads in. We done with the first square. We make in total 4 of these. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and please thumbs up under my videos. Click on the bell so you don't miss any of my new upload tutorials. You can find me also on Facebook and Instagram and my website biancascrochetparlors.com. Here's a suggestion for another video. I hope you like it. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye!